romantic place in the whole world. We could go anywhere right now. We could stop right now before anybody sees us. Go back to the airport.
You've got
to
be kidding.
Hop the next plane to, say, Paris or something. Actually, what might be better is even to just close our eyes, point at any old place on the departure board, and take the luck of the draw. How about that? Come on, I don't care where it is, anywhere, as long as it's with you. It doesn't matter.
Is it that obvious?
Well, you have barely said anything since we touched down on the runway. Come on, sweetie, come on, let's blow this castle.
You're amazing.
How do you hail a cab in Hungarian?
No way.
Why? Why not?
No.
This will be our first wacky adventure.
This is our first wacky adventure together, sweetheart. You know, the first time I was here, I had to scale the walls just to get in. You see those big iron babies just open right up for us? No more skulking around in the wine cellar. Nope. I'm officially palace approved. And now I have this beautiful bride on my arm. I've arrived. That's it. Okay, I just needed a few minutes to catch my breath. I'm fine. Let's go. All systems go.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure. Now all I gotta do is find the master suite without waking up the entire household. Unless you want some cold goulash sandwiches first.
Let's find that suite.
My feelings, exactly. Get the door.
Got it.
Welcome home.
You're home. Good.
What's wrong?
I know I have no right to ask you this, but I don't know what else to do, and there's no other way.
What is it?
I need a loan, fast.
Did I forget a tuition payment?
No, of course not.
But fees, lab costs, books add up. All right, I'll call the account first thing in the morning. You'll have a check by the afternoon.
I don't need pocket change, and I can't wait till morning. I need a lot of money, tonight.
Tell me you're not bailing out Kendall.
Yes, I am.
I'm not lifting a finger to help you, Kendall. You're on your own.
On my own? How?
Well, you're a smart girl. I'm sure you will mastermind a brilliant strategy to get yourself out of this.
I need a lawyer.
Yes, the court will appoint one for you.
Well, some guy came in, but he's a cretin.
Aren't we all compared to you?
Well, I need a real lawyer. You're supposed to be helping me.
All right, of course, yes. Well, let me think about this then. Yes. Well, first thing tomorrow morning, I'm going to call the Bar Association, and I will have them send you a list of preferred attorneys.
What are you trying to pull?
Call a criminal lawyer. You pick one. And talk fast, Kendall, really, because the clock will be ticking away hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
You know I don't have any money.
Oh, well, that's going to make it harder, isn't it?
Is this your sick idea of a joke? Well, what are you trying to do to me?
Give you the benefit of my experience?
You swore you would help me if I helped you. You promised. If I changed my testimony, you were going to take care of me.
Yes, I did, didn't I?
You gave me your word.
My solemn word? Yes, you're absolutely right. Well, guess what, Kendall? I lied.
Children. Brought to you by AT&T. We help put your world within reach.
Marta, your hand on the stander, the bags, please.
Oh, listen, you don't have to get those. I can slip them up myself.
Madame Andrasche, I'm honored. Oh,
Well, thank you.
Does she think that I'm somebody else?
It's a long story.
Please allow me to take your coat. Thank you.
Thank you. Wow.
I feel like I just walked into a Hans Christian Andersen theme park. Who's Count Andrassy?
Dimitri's Count Andrassy.
No.
Mm-hmm.
You're serious.
And I'm the discount. You can call me Lord and Master. Just kidding.
I could only scrape together a simple meal. Rakot krumpli, dios tiestat, sirke paprikas, shambos gumbit.
Sounds good to her.
It's quite kind of you, but it's insufficient for an important occasion like this. I would have made head weather tokane, 7 chieftains stew, but the butcher was closed.
There are only 5 chieftains in the freezer.
Kidding.
Whatever you have is fine, believe me. I mean, thank you very much.
You are very kind, but Master's first night at Vadzel should have been perfect.
I am completely bowled over by this.
Really? I mean, I feel like I walked into a coronation ball.
No, not enough, not nearly enough. But I'll do my best to make it up during your stay. Now, if you excuse me, I must see to dinner.
Sorry.
You're apologizing?
Well, you know, that quick little beeline to the master bedroom, I don't think it's gonna happen.
Well, we'll get there.
No, not anytime soon. My Hungarian's a little rusty, but I could have sworn I heard her say 5-course meal, possibly 6.
Well, you know, Corvina is lovely, but is there any way to get her to lighten up?
There is no way.
No, really?
No. You know her brother, Anton?
Yeah?
Well, you might think he's a little on the serious side.
So you're saying it runs in the blood?
I'm saying he's not going to MC the Comedy Awards. But next to him, well, let's just say he's a wild and crazy guy compared to her.
Have you lost your mind?
Kendall's father is dead. She's alone now.
My heart bleeds.
She's in jail, Dimitri.
Where she belongs.
So she's made some mistakes.
Mistakes?
She doesn't belong with hardened criminals.
Don't kid yourself. She's as hard as they come.
She's young.
Oh, Anton, please.
And stupid, yes. And maybe a little neurotic. But she's also sincerely sorry.
I don't want to hear it.
You saw how remorseful she was on the witness stand. That wasn't an act.
How could you tell?
I know, Kendall.
After everything that she's put us through, you're still pleading her case? What's wrong with you, Anton?
Look, I know she's done a lot of damage, but putting her in jail is not going to help anyone.
It's time for the little witch to take a long, hard look at herself. Jail is just the place to do it.
You can't believe that.
No one to prey on but other inmates even meaner and colder than she is.
But Erica's the one who's cold and mean now.
Wait a minute. How did Erica get into this?
Erica swore that if Kendall changed her testimony, she'd save her from prosecution. Except it was a trap, a lie. Because now that Kendall's in jail, Erica won't lift a finger to help her. She set Kendall up, and now she's letting her twist in the wind. Pretty sick, huh?
I think it's the healthiest thing Erica's ever done.
You flat out lied. I never had any intention of saving your hide. The valley in the checking account? Those were nice touches, weren't they? I put my life in your hands. You were kind. You were compassionate.
Yes, I was.
You did all of this just to hurt me?
Of course not. Kendall, you came to me. You came to me begging my forgiveness for all the lies you told. You offered to do anything. I had to get you to exonerate me.
I did. I told the truth.
Oh, yes, you were just wonderful. You were quivering with emotion. You were Lillian Gish in her prime.
I wasn't acting.
Yeah, that's why it was all the more impressive. I don't mind telling you, though. I really didn't think you had it in you to tell that much truth at one sitting.
I was so grateful to you.
Of course you were. Self-interest is the way to your heart. I had to hang that carrot in front of you as bait, although I must tell you I was very surprised at how quickly you took that bait. Somehow, Kendall, I thought you were savvier than that. Well, you beware of victims bearing gifts. That's just a word of advice for your future.
I don't have a future.
Oh, yes, you do. You have a lot of education ahead of you. You can learn so much in a penal institution.
All the plans, everything was a lie?
Maybe not. Maybe I never promised you anything. You know, Kendall, you've been under so much stress lately. Maybe you were hallucinating. You know what? When you get to Plattsville, you must see the psychiatrist there.
How can you do this to me?
You try remembering the feeling that you got when you told me, Erica. You're crazy. Erica, Dimitri never raped me. You know, for a split second, I thought that I had lost my grip. But I'm back in full force now. And if I ever doubted myself, well, the look on your face is proof positive.
Cannon and Frye.
When did you start that?
Just a goof. What's up?
Well, I just opened the greatest wedding present.
Pilfering through Edmund and Maria's presents already, huh?
No, silly. This one's for me. I'll give you a hint. It has 900 square feet, a color TV, and lots of leftover wedding cake in the fridge.
Sounds like you got your own apartment.
Yeah, and there's a Joan Crawford classic on The Late Show. So when can you come over?
Ooh, love the idea, but... not tonight.
Oh, how come?
Well, between the wedding rehearsal and then the wedding... Well, excuse me, I'm sorry. The rehearsal dinner and the wedding, I'm way behind on my research paper.
Terrence, you still mad at me?
No, I'm not mad. I'm just... Look, I'm real tired. It's been a long day. And don't make it a big deal, okay?
Okay.
I'll talk to you soon.
Spring's almost here, and you choose to hibernate now?
Funny.
I couldn't help but overhear. You and Julia aren't still fighting around me.
No, we're not fighting about you. That was a aberration.
That's reassuring.
We're not fighting. We're just in different time zones.
What does that mean?
Well, she's in a speed race to be joined at the hip, and I'm idling here in the slow lane.
Classic dilemma. Get used to it. It's the price you pay when you're, Whatever.
Whatever? What's whatever?
Suffice it to say that the average woman is going to take one look at you and hear wedding bells.
Yeah, right. Like there's a line outside.
Any day now.
Right. Well, anyway, who says that I want an average woman? Who says that I'm not waiting for way above average?
I wouldn't touch that with a 10-foot pole.
Well, truth is, I don't know what I'm waiting for. Just hasn't hit me yet.
It?
You know, that thing that drives you at night. You know, make you get out when you're tired, you know you gotta work,